All right, here we go, as promised. Get yourself a pit towel from Walmart or the dollar store, wherever. Get yourself a block of wood. Set your car on as a car stand to begin with. You know, and here's the Legends car I was talking about. I'm going to show you a few things right off the bat. You'll notice the car kit comes with wires and locking collars, and you'll want to go with turnbuckles and ball cups. These are called ball cups. They are way sturdier and much more precise when racing. You'll need ball studs to go in the servo saver, which is right here, attaches to your servo. They're threaded. One of them is left hand, one of them is right hand, so as you turn it, it adjusts in and out. It's just like a tie rod on a real race car. You'll notice that the speed controller and the receiver are pretty much centrally located in the chassis. The motor is mounted on the left side of the chassis. We're going to put it back on the right side of the chassis. And if you look underneath the car, you'll see the battery is pretty much centrally located. There's almost the same amount of space in front of the battery as there is behind the battery. Scott set his servo up with a servo mount right here and drilled the hole through the radio tray to mount the servo solid, in addition to using two-sided servo tape. I don't know if you can see it, but it's right in here. That's two-sided servo tape in there to stick the servo in and mount it good and solid. We're going to go over some things. You'll notice there's a little bit of play in the front bushings. We'll replace those eventually. Both sides, the car has been raced for approximately maybe a little more than a month. Spectrum receiver, Spectrum radio, inexpensive setup, nothing too crazy. The speed controller that is in there is a Quick Run 1060, which is an inexpensive speed controller. When you put the car together, you want to make sure that the cross braces in the chassis spin. You don't want everything rigidly put together. You want to have a little bit of play in your chassis. Because as you can see, as I pick the car up, the chassis flexes. You want flex in the chassis. And I don't know if you can see it, but as I move the chassis, the motor moves a little bit. We're going to talk about rebuilding the differential, gear mesh between the two, switching the motor back to the other side. We're going to do a few things here and go over this car, and I'll show you how to do some stuff that will make it a tuner's car a little bit quicker than out of the box. So let me get it apart, and I'll get back to you with the next clip. Alright, as I'm disassembling this to rebuild the diff, you see those marks right there on the axle? Those score marks? This hub right here goes on the axle. Okay, and those set screws are what hold the axle in place. And if you don't take a Dremel, you know, a Dremel tool or a file or something of that nature, and file or grind a flat where those set screw goes, this axle is going to spin in the hub. It's going to spin in the hub and you're going to lose traction, and it's going to pull to one side and you're not going to be able to figure out what's going on. You're going to be pulling your hair out. So when you set your car up, get your axle where you want it, tighten on the set screw to make a little mark in the axle, and then take your Dremel and grind a little flat spot on the axle so that the set screw has somewhere flat to grab onto. It doesn't take a whole lot. You don't got to grind off half the axle. Just a little flat spot to get it. And I'll show you how to do that when we get to that point. But first, let's get the axle out and I'll show you what's next. Alright, that's the diff hub right there. The diff ring goes on the other side. You see how shiny that is right there? That side goes inside the hub like that, and then your diff ring goes on the outside. What happens is, if you don't super glue the diff ring into the hub, the diff ring spins, which will also cause your car to do erratic things. So we're going to rectify that situation. I'm going to show you how to do this stuff in hopes that you get something out of it and make your racing a lot more fun. It's stuff that doesn't come in the instructions. They don't tell you how to do a lot of this stuff. It's stuff that you learn through experience. Alright, next clip. I'll be back. Alright, you need a drill and your axle. You're going to need some 400 wet dry paper and some 600 wet dry paper. And you're going to cut a little piece like this and take some oil, some WD-40, whatever you got on hand, some penetrating oil, whatever you want to use. I have some RDP oil here that I'll use out of my toolbox. Put a couple drops on the sandpaper. Okay. Let me set this up on the tripod here. Get your drill going pretty slow. Wrap your sandpaper around your axle and start polishing your axle. Just slow. Don't have to go crazy. Do the sandpaper back and forth. I'm trying to get all those burrs off there from where the hub was spinning. Start off with the rougher grit. This is 400, like I said. Okay. You're also going to need some blue paper towels or shop towels, paper towels, whatever you got on hand. Polish it up with the 400, cut a small piece of 600, and then go with the 600 and the oil like I showed you, same as the 400. Let me get my scissors here. I hope this is all in frame. I hope you guys can see this. Hope I'm not out of frame. Wrap the 600 around with a little bit of oil on there. Start polishing away. If you go too fast, it'll get hot. You won't be able to hold on to it. oil helps the sandpaper cut quicker and last longer. If you've never used wet or dry paper to polish anything, polish it up good. You are going to get dirty. This all goes into preparation. This is easier to do as you build your kit than it is to do after you put your car together. As you do it, it's much, much easier to do. So there's our two pieces of sandpaper. We're going to take our blue paper towel and wipe off all the oil and see what we got. Wow, look at that. That's awesome. Okay, now I'm going to cut this blue paper towel off a little bit here. Make sure not to cut my pit towel. Now you want to go to your local hardware store and pick up some sort of metal polish. This is what I got at the hardware store. It was only like $6 or $8, I think. Give it a good shake. Apply a liberal amount to the towel. And then start polishing with your towel. Now you want to be careful in this step and don't go too fast because it'll wrap up around your axle and you could get hurt. So just go slow and polish away. Keep moving. You'll see the polish compound start to turn black. That means it's doing its job. Stop, move to another part of the towel with fresh compound, and continue to polish. Apply gentle pressure. Like I said, don't overheat the axle to the point where you can't hold on to it anymore. Just polish it up as good as you can so you're happy with the results. As you can see, where I've been polishing, the towel is black. Move to a fresh part of the towel. Proceed. Look at that, it's like chrome. Okay, the next tip is you take your rear axle bushings right there and you pop those out and polish those. And I'll show you how to do that. Okay, here we have our bushings and our axle is still in the drill. We're gonna take our polishing compound, put a little bit of polishing compound on the axle. And then we're going to place our bushings on the axle and slide them through the polishing compound like this, back and forth. Smear the compound around, place them on your axle. And then hold the bushings slightly and move them back and forth just like you did the sandpaper, while the axle's spinning in the drill. Okay, now you've polished your bushings, you've polished your axle. We're going to get ready to rebuild and reassemble the differential. I'll show you how to polish your differings and super glue your diff side aluminum hub back into the hub so it doesn't spin on you. And we'll go from there. You're going to need Q-tips and the blue towels and some cheap isopropyl alcohol to clean all this stuff. I don't have motor spray or brake cleaner or anything like that, but you got to make sure before you put this stuff back together, clean all the polish out of your bushings with alcohol and a Q-tip. Clean your axle thoroughly with alcohol and Q-tips. You'll notice all the oil and grease on your differing. You got to clean all that off so we can super glue the differings to the axle after we polish the differings. You want to clean everything. You got to clean your gear, clean all the old carpet remnants and diff lube out of there. Make sure your gears are still in good condition. Make sure it's got no teeth missing. No teeth missing! And make sure you put back the diff balls with lubricant. I'll show you what I use here in a minute. Okay, you're going to want to get a flat surface. Cut yourself a small piece of 600 grit sandpaper. And of course, once again, add a few drops of lubricant to the sandpaper to help it cut and polish better. And then you can take your diff side, your hub side of the diff, place the diff ring on the hub and put it on the paper. So we're going to do this one-handed. Put it on the paper. Get this on the tripod here. Hold the paper and move the diff ring in a circular fashion. Now you want to do this on a flat surface, like I said, like a nice flat block of wood, a cutting board, a piece of picture frame glass from an old picture frame you got laying around. Anything that's good and flat. You want to polish your differings so that they work properly. These things are just stamped out. They're not really flat. After they've been used for a while, they get a little groove in them. You can get a couple uses out of a set by polishing one side, using it till your diff feels like crap, and then flipping them over. Even though you've super glued them to the hub, the super glue generally will turn loose on metal. I'm not going to spend, 5 minutes sanding these. I'll show you the results when I'm done. So I'll be right back. All right, take your blue towel and your alcohol. Get your blue towel wet with alcohol. And proceed to clean everything. Like I said, that you just polished. Clean your differings. Clean everything really good. Get all the oil and residue off. Check to make sure that everything is polished the way you want it. I only polished one side of these because I saved the other side for later. That way I know which side is which. Here's the hub that goes into the diff side that goes into the hub. Clean everything real thoroughly. Get all the oil off. Prepare for super glue. Both sides, back and front. Get everything off you can. Okay. Now, you got to get the super glue from the hobby shop or the hardware store. I have stuff here from my local hobby shop, Hobbytown. Hobbytown was $3.99. It's Instacure, Hobbytown brand. I'm going to take the diff side hub and show you how to glue the aluminum into the hub. As soon as I find my little pliers to get the lid off. Alright, I got the lid off. Alright. Now, you just need a little bit. You don't need to overdo it with the super glue. You just need a little bit to hold it in there and hold it in place. Okay, so take your super glue, take your hub, put a little bit of super glue in there. That's all you need, just a little bit. Make sure you get it all the way around. This is Instacure, like I said, so it only takes a couple seconds for it to dry. Put a little bit on the hub, on the diff ring, and press it together. That's it. Simple Simon. Now, you take your diff ring and got them all clean and ready to go. And all you need is just a little bit on the diff side, a drop there. Turn your diff, put a drop there. And make sure you place the side you sanded up. Okay, now you let that dry. Now we'll proceed to clean the gear and rebuild the diff. You want to, like I said, pop out the old diff balls. These are disposable. Don't ever reuse them. They get flat spots on them and they're garbage. So take your Q-tip or your motor spray or your brake cleaner and get you some alcohol on a Q-tip. Clean your gear thoroughly. Make sure you get all the old grease. Look at all that old crap. It's already black. I just touched it. You're going to want to rebuild your diff pretty often. I can't stress to you guys enough how important your differential is to the performance of your car. It has to be ultra smooth. I'll show you when we get it together what I'm talking about. You how to adjust it and how to get it where it needs to be for best performance. Clean both sides of the gear. Try to get as much stuff off as you can. Use Q-tips, paper towels. The motor spray and the brake cleaner work really well. They wash that stuff off. I don't have any, or else I'd be using it myself. Wipe it off with a towel. Get it clean. Let it air dry. Make sure you throw your dip balls away. You're not going to use those ones. Here's the diff lube that I'm using. RDP diff lube. Standard size diff balls. They come in a pack of 100. You can usually pick these up at the local hobby shop. You go through a lot of them, guys. Don't be scared. They're only a few bucks. The diff lube's only a few bucks. But you take your diff lube and you take anything like an X-Acto knife, Allen driver, whatever you can, and scoop out a little bit of diff lube and you put it in the holes where you're going to put your diff balls. And you don't need a whole lot. Just get it in there a little bit at a time. Very carefully, take your time. Go back for some more if you need some more. A lot of guys don't use all the holes. I like to do all the holes and use all the diff balls. I think, in my mind, in my opinion, it makes for a better diff build. But a lot of guys only use half the diff balls, which, you know, works out fine for them. That's cool. You do what works for you. And I'm more partial to using all of them. Now, there's a little trick. There's a little grease left on the end of the Allen driver. You stick that little bit of grease in there and pick them diff balls up out of that thing one at a time and pop them in your gear with your finger and they just snap right in. You know, you can get a couple at a time. You drop a couple. Yeah, you always drop a couple, but your finger... I can't talk. If your fingers got grease on them, chances are your diff ball is going to stick to it. So you can pick them up pretty easy that way and pop them in. Have trouble pushing in with your Allen driver? Get another one, drop it in place. If you can't get it in with your finger, push it in with your Allen driver. They generally pop right in there, especially if the gear has been used previously. But like I said, I cannot stress to you enough, this is a common procedure. You need to do the maintenance and prepare the diff. All right, we're back. We got the super glue to work. Okay, you just take a little bit. Put it on here. One or two drops is all you need to hold the diff ring in place. I'm going to ride right around, spin the axle. The one drop I put on there goes all the way around. Take your diff ring, make sure you put the polished side up to the diff. Place it on there. Take a Q-tip, get off the excess super glue. All the super glue is off. I just wiped the Q-tip around there. Everything is nice and clean. Now we start to assemble the diff. Okay, you put your gear on. Your gear's on there. And then your diff side hub to put your wheel on goes on next. Yeah, I'm okay with that. That's a little tough, but it's all right. Okay, now you got those pieces together. Now you got your thrust washer and your cone washers that go on next. Now, clean this with alcohol the same way you've been cleaning everything else. Q-tip and alcohol. Just take some alcohol, rub it on there. Get all the oil off, all the old crud. Both sides. Now you can do one of two things here. You can get your diff lube back out and put your diff lube on it. Or you can get your oil out and put a couple drops of oil on it. Just a little bit of oil on each bearing is all you need. Okay, flat washer goes on first. Flat washer, thrust washer, and your cone washers. And make sure you put the flat washer and then the cone washer on just like the instructions say to you. And then take your diff nut and apply your diff nut. Now, as you can probably see, I cut off the excess axle here with a Dremel and a cutoff wheel so that I could use a regular nut driver to adjust my differential. I don't need like a deep well socket or anything like that. He had this thing together, and where he had the diff was pretty close, so I just left it all together and trimmed off the excess axle so that the nut driver would go on there. Because the nut driver I had would not go on there because it wasn't deep enough. So that is your diff assembly. That is polished, ready to be put back together, and ready to be adjusted. Now, the next thing is installing it back in the car. We've got the motor on this side. We want to put it on this side because in my mind, you're going into the turn, the weight is transferred to the right rear. And by putting the motor on the left rear, you're not doing it justice. So, clean your bushings with alcohol and a Q-tip, like I said. Get all the polishing compound off. Get all the polishing compound out of there. And you'll see, if you look closely in there, I don't know if the light will show you, but they are polished. Nice and shiny. Clean off all the debris from polishing. Get ready to reinstall your rear axle and your freshly built diff. Some guys, these inserts right here for the axle bushing can go two ways. They can go down or up. One will lower your ride height, the other will raise your ride height. You can decide what works best for you. I'm going to leave them alone. So let's install the bushings. They just press in. Very simple. The 3/32 Allen driver takes the motor out. RJ Speed makes an optional heat sink for these cars that goes between the chassis plate and the motor and takes away some of the heat from the motor. Now, real race cars, you know, the aspect that heat is the enemy of horsepower. So the cooler you can keep your motor, the better off you're going to be. So we're going to flip it around. We might have to do a little bit of, we might have to change the rotation of the motor. I don't know if that's going to still be the same, moving it from side to side or not. I'm not a genius. I don't know. Well, we'll get the motor in. I'll slide the axle in and tighten things up a bit. And then we'll talk about gear mesh and how to adjust your gear mesh. If you apply a little bit of ingenuity to what you're doing, spec class racing is a whole lot of fun. Everybody has to use the same tires, the same motor, the same car. They're limited to the tuning, so you have to do things in order to make it work right. So now we're going to slide the axle back in, but before we do that, I'm going to go ahead and grind a flat on two sides of this axle so that I can tighten the set screws on the other hub. I'll be right back as soon as I get that ready. Now, when you set up the axle in the rear end, you want side play. Not a lot, just a couple of thousandths. So as you tighten up your hub, make sure you got it on the flat spot. Tighten it down a little bit. Okay, there's no side play. So hold on to it, loosen it up, and slide it over just a little bit. Tighten it back down. Snug it back down. Slide it over. Oh, that's way too much. Loosen it up. Loosen it up, slide it together, pull it apart a couple thousandths, snug it down. Just a bit much. Now you're going to want to check this in between rounds. Because if you're new to RC racing and you're hitting the boards a little bit and your rear tire smacks the board, it's going to collapse that gap and cause binding. You don't want anything to bind. You want everything to move really, really free. That's why you polish the axle and polish the bushings. There we go. Now you can barely see the side play. And you keep working it till you're happy with what you got. It doesn't take a lot. That's not enough. That's way too much. That could be just about right. I like a little less than that. Give it a little peck. We're going to go with that. That's pretty good. Flip it over. Snug down the other Allen screw. Remember, don't over tighten them. It's just plastic. Okay, that's pretty good. Now, everything moves free. See? Everything is real free. And you want to check your side play, like I said, in between rounds. And every round before you go out, you want to oil your bushings. Oil your bushings. I don't care if it's sewing machine oil. It doesn't have to be anything crazy. No, it doesn't have to be any kind of special racing oil. That stuff there I got is from RDP, which is Tom Postlewaite. We call him the Postman. He's a real fast racer. Real good guy. Okay, now, to adjust your gear mesh, you're going to want to make sure that you do this methodically. Move your motor over to your gear. Make sure your screws are loose and everything moves freely. I generally make the gears touch totally, so you don't move, and then I back it off just a little bit, and then I snug one screw down. As you tighten the screws, see how I'm holding the motor? I'm holding it on the top and the bottom with my thumb, like this. As you tighten these screws, the motor is going to want to move. So bring the gear together, back it off a little bit, snug down one screw. See it move totally. As you snug them down, everything is going to want to move. So back it off a little. Hold on to it the best you can. Snug it down. Tighten the top one there. Snug it down a little bit. And check your gear mesh. Too tight. Loosen that screw again. Back it off. This takes a little bit of doing. This is not something that you should just be in a hurry to do. This is something that has to be done right every time. We're running a 13-tooth pinion at Rug Runner, so that's what everybody is running. Okay, that feels pretty good. Now, once it feels pretty good, rotate your gear and feel it elsewhere. Gears are plastic, nothing is perfect. Make sure it feels good all the way around. Okay, when it does, tighten up your bottom screw. And put some good torque on them. Don't let them come loose on you. You know, if you hit the wall, the motor has a chance of moving. Okay, so let's go over what we just did. We rebuilt the diff, super glued the diff side of the hub, super glued the diff rings to the hubs, polished the axle, polished the bushings, oiled the bushings, set our side play, and set our gear mesh. Now, I don't know if you can see Exactly. I'm moving the gear with my finger. There's only a couple thousandths gear mesh slapping that. See that? Now we're going to put the tires on, and I'm going to show you how to adjust your diff. All right? I'll be right back. All right, tires are back on. When you put your tires on, through your 3/32 Allen driver, I typically tighten the screws down until they stop. Then I only go a quarter turn past that, because remember, the hubs on this are plastic. You don't want to over tighten anything. All right, now you take your nut driver, insert it onto your axle. You want to hold each tire with both hands and put your thumb on the wheel, on the spur gear. Now as you tighten your diff with the nut driver, hold the tires and try to turn the spur gear with your thumb. You want to get it to the point where you tighten it just a little bit at a time until you can no longer turn the spur gear, or you can just barely turn the spur gear with your thumb. It should take a lot of force to turn the spur gear. So hold the tires, tighten the nut driver a little bit at a time, hold the tires and try to turn the spur gear. Okay, so now I can turn the spur gear with my thumb real easy. So I tighten it up a little bit at a time, but I can still turn it, tighten it up a little bit more. I can barely turn it. Now, that's smooth. That's smooth, boys. That's what you want. The diff is adjusted right where it needs to be. It's been rebuilt. Everything is smooth. There's one little other thing I'd like to address. Wire management. You see that wire right there? It's been chafing against the chassis. Now you can either unsolder it and move it, or you can try to take your needle nose pliers and bend the tab away from the chassis a little bit. I think we're going to try to unsolder it and actually move the wire away from the chassis, headed 180 degrees, or maybe, no, not that much, maybe 90 degrees or 45 degrees away from the chassis, so it doesn't rub. Wire management is important. You start to look for problems like this. I started running indoor carpet off-road at the gate in Brunswick with a brand new car, brand new speed controller. Everything was brand new right out of the box. And the second time I ran, I let another guy drive it to tell me maybe what needed to happen with the setup. And he was driving it and it just suddenly quit. So the car comes back and the speed controller wire for a brand new speed controller is wrapped around the drive shaft of the car. So be careful where you put your wires. Make note of what your car is doing, and be conscious of what's going on. Be mindful of what's happening. All right, we're going to address the front end next.
The land of race car yayas. The land where you can't change lanes. The land where large fuzzy dice still